which one of you guys is the DJ?
Oh, that's me, Wink Dickerson from KRUT Radio.
Far out, Dink. Hey,
no,
listen,
no, that's
man,
Wink. Wink Dickerson from KRUT Radio.
Oh, yeah, well, far out. Listen, man, do you want to give me your name, man? I'm supposed to introduce you after the next act, Dink.
Yeah, well, like I said, it's Wink Dickerson from KRUT Radio.
Yeah, Dink.
Perhaps you've caught my show, Wink's Wax to Watch, on Saturday from 12 to 1.
No, man. I'm really not... AM.
Oh, I see. You know, well, remember, it's 11,111 on your radio dial.
Oh, yeah, man. I'll write that down. I think my sister listens to you once.
Oh, far out.
So listen, man, are you ready to go on?
Oh, right on.
Oh, man. I'm far out, man. Okay, man, I'm going to go out and announce you now. Are you ready?
Sure, I'm ready anytime you are. Don't forget, it's Wink.
3 weeks ago, the American spacecraft Discovery 1 left on its half-billion mile voyage.
All right, testing. Hey, is this thing on? Testing.
Earlier this afternoon, the world tonight recorded an interview.
Is this thing on? Can you hear me back there?
Distance of 80 million miles.
Shut up. All right.
Our reporter, Marty Neymar, speaks to the crew.
I'm supposed to introduce
the crew of Discovery 1 consists of 5 men and one of the latest generation of the HAL 9000 computers. 3 of the 5 men were put aboard asleep, or to be more precise, in a state of hibernation. We spoke with Mission Commander Dr. David Bowman and his deputy, Dr. Frank Poole. Well, good afternoon, gentlemen. How's everything going?
Marvelous. We have no complaints.
Well, I'm very glad to hear that, and I'm sure that the entire world would join me in wishing you a safe and successful voyage.
Thanks very much.
Thank you. The 6th member of the Discovery crew was not concerned about the problems of hibernation, for he was the latest result in machine intelligence, the HAL 9000 computer. Good afternoon, Hal. How's everything going?
Good afternoon, Mr. Raymer. Everything is going extremely well.
Hal, you have an enormous responsibility on this mission. In many ways, perhaps the greatest responsibility of any single mission element. Does this ever cause you any lack of confidence?
Let me put it this way, Mr. Raymer. The 9000 series is the most reliable computer ever made. No 9000 computer has ever made a mistake or distorted information. We are all, by any practical definition of the words, foolproof and incapable of error.
Well, hell, I'm damned if I can find anything wrong with it.
Yes. I would recommend that we put the unit back in operation and let it fail.
X-ray Delta 1, this is Mission Control. We concur with your plan to replace number 1 unit to check fault prediction. We should advise you, however, that our preliminary findings indicate that you're on board a 9000 computer is in error predicting the fault. I say again, in error predicting the fault. Sorry about this mistake, fellas.
I hope the two of you are not concerned about this.
Oh, I'm not, Al.
This sort of thing has cropped up before, and it has always been due to human error.
Well, I'm sure you're right, Hal. Fine. Thanks very much.
Hal, despite your enormous intellect, are you ever frustrated by your dependence on people to carry out actions?
Not in the slightest bit. I enjoy working with people. I have a stimulating relationship with Dr. Poole and Dr. Bowman.
Still, I can't think of a good reason not to put back the number 1 unit and carry on with the 30 mode analysis.
No, no, I agree about that. Let's say we put the unit back and it doesn't fail. That would pretty well wrap it up as far as Hal is concerned with it. If it were proven to be malfunctioning, I wouldn't see how we'd have any choice but disconnection.
I'm afraid I agree with you.
There'd be nothing else to do.
You know, another thing just occurred to me. Well, as far as I know, no 9000 computers have been disconnected.
Ever found it before.
That's not what I mean. Well, I'm not so sure. What do you think about it?
my mission responsibilities range over the entire operation of the ship, so I am constantly occupied. I am putting myself to the fullest possible use, which is all I think that any conscious entity can ever hope to do.
Open the pod bay doors, please, Hal. Do you read me, Hal?
Hello, Hal, do you read me?
Thank you.
Thank you.